Are you applying for jobs in Australia? And you never hear back from recruiters after applying the job? Is your resume tailored for the Australian job search? Welcome to the series Job Search in Australia, and in this video, I'll share 5 awesome resume tips for your job search. Let me tell you what happened when two friends decided to hang out one evening. The very first thing I want to mention is always remember the very purpose of having a resume. It is not to list out everything that you have done in your career. It is to get you an interview call. Now look at your resume and ask yourself these 3 questions. Would this resume get you the interview call for the job you've applied for? Is it unique enough? Is it easy for the recruiter to identify that your profile stands out? Or is it a 7-page letter that lists out everything you've done so far in your career, which may or may not be related to the job advertised? So, first and foremost, start with a good CV template. There are quite a few websites which provides you with CV templates. You can even look at good CV templates on the web and create your own. I would move away from the blandness of black and white to a more pleasing format, but stick to being professional unless you are in a creative field like photography or artistry. Tip number 2, what should be the length of the CV? This is one question I never got a straight answer for. And when I was new in Australia, it left me perplexed. In American job market, the CV length is not more than 1 or maximum 2 pages. However, in Australia, the industry practice recommends more details, which brings the CV to 2 to 3 pages. My personal sweet spot is 3 pages if you have a long career summary. For shorter career summary, 2 pages are good enough. Tip number 3. Tailor your resume for each job ad. Do not ever use the same resume for all the jobs you apply. Spend time on your CV. If you're spending 10 minutes to quickly fix the keywords, the chances of you getting shortlisted is very narrow. Tip number 4. Most important and most ignored, mention only relevant responsibilities. You might be capable of doing 14 other tasks, but you do not need to list all of them in your resume. It is difficult for a hiring manager to figure out what your key specializations are. If you have listed 20 responsibilities out of which only 5 is needed for the job, believe it or not, it does more damage to you than good. Keep your CV crisp and to the point. Short sentences are your friends. If it is not easy to read and has a lot of jargons which is specific to your field, may not be understood by your hiring manager, resulting in rejections. Tip number 5. Keywords, keywords, and keywords. If the job ad mentions operational experience and you have mentioned operations, I'm sorry to say, my friend, but that's a keyword mismatch. Before you go, there are some final tips I want to share with you. So watch it till the end. Quantify your achievements. Highlight the value you brought into the team or the company by mentioning numbers. What are the changes you brought in? Was it a 20% increase in customer base? Was it 10% increase in productivity? It is easy to visualize when you mention numbers. Use power words. That will help you stand out. Thank you for watching this video. Comment below and let us know if these tips were helpful to you. And do not forget to share with your friends and subscribe to Dream Infinity.